Hello everyone, Reza here. In this video, I will show you how to use the new stream control in Power Apps that allows us to embed Microsoft Stream videos on SharePoint directly in Canvas Power Apps. I'll demonstrate how to build a video library in SharePoint and create a video library experience in Power Apps and play the videos inline thanks to the new stream control. So let's check it out in action. The new stream control requires the stream URL. To add a stream video to your Canvas app, I have a document library in SharePoint where I have hosted some video files. I'll select a specific video. This will open in Microsoft Stream. I need the stream URL. To get that, I'll head over to Share, click Embed Code. Here, the source attribute has the code. All you have to do is copy the code all the way up until the unique ID property. Copy this, head back to my Power App. Stream URL under double quotes, I'll paste the link. As long as the user running the Power App has access to that specific stream video that's linked, the stream control will load the video and I can play the video directly in the Canvas Power App. You get all the video controls. You also get details about the video from Stream. Commands, video settings, video analytics, and more. I can also share this right here from the control experience itself. Now in this library of mine called videos, I have 4 video files. In my Power App, I would like to build a video gallery. First, I'll connect to SharePoint, connect to my SharePoint site. I'll select my document library called videos and connect. So I have a connection to my videos library in my screen container. I'll go and insert a vertical gallery and connect this to my videos library. I have an image control. The image property for this, I can use this item.thumbnail. I'll use the large version of the thumbnail. For videos that you upload in SharePoint, SharePoint itself generates thumbnails. And since this is a gallery control, I can select a specific file from my gallery. Now for a selected file, I would like the stream control to show that specific video. So I'll go and add the stream control, stream URL. Stream URL is not a property that the document library exposes out of the box. I do need the metadata for stream ID to be available in this library. So I can use that value to frame the URL for embedding the video in the stream control in Power Apps. So for that, I'll add a text column. I'll call this unique ID. This is where I would like to put that value. Now one option is open the video in stream. Go to Share, Embed, and get the unique ID. And I can put that value in this column. However, I would want this process to be automated. And for automation, we can leverage Power Automate. I'll go and create an automated Cloudflow that triggers when a file is created in SharePoint. I'll give the flow a name and click Create. The flow should trigger when a file is created in my videos library. I need the unique ID that is not available as a property, but we can get that by leveraging the send an HTTP request to SharePoint action. We'll use a REST API call to get that ID. I'll pick my SharePoint site. The URI will be API web lists get by title. In single quotes, I'll put the name of my document library / items. Under brackets, I need to put the ID of the newly created file. I can get that from dynamic content, property ID, ?, $select. I'll select the file property, and from here, get me the unique ID of the file. And file is a complex type column, so I'll have to expand it as well. $expand is equal to file. This will give me the unique ID, which is what I need to frame that stream URL. And next step, I'll add an action, update file properties, SharePoint, connect to my SharePoint site, connect to my videos library. Unique ID will come from my trigger. Click show all. The column I created is called unique ID. Here, I'll go and plug in an expression. The expression will be body bracket under single quotes, send an HTTP request to SharePoint. Exactly the same name, case sensitive, as my send an HTTP request to SharePoint action. For spaces, I'll put an underscore, ?, under square brackets, single quotes, D, ?, under square brackets, single quotes, file, ?, unique ID. Expression is done. I'll click add. My flow is complete. I'll click save. The flow has saved and is ready to go. I'll upload a few video files. I have uploaded 3 files. My flow has triggered. You can see how the unique IDs are automatically populated. Back to my Power App. I'll refresh the connection to my videos library since I added that new column, which is unique ID. My gallery is set. My stream control URL is what I need to plug in. Now for a specific video, copy this URL up until unique ID. And in my Power App, I will paste it in double quotes in the stream URL property. Unique ID is what I would like to get dynamically based on an item selected in the gallery. So I'll remove the hard-coded GUID here for unique ID. Put an ampersand to concatenate this string with my gallery control, which is gallery 1 in my case, .selected.uniqueID. Now if I preview, you will note as I select a specific video, the stream control will load that specific video and allow me to play it right here in the Power App. And we can expand on this experience. I have a document library called Video Hub that has video files. I have a column for title that I have populated with metadata. I also have a choice column called category, so I can categorize my videos. Stream ID is that unique ID that I am dynamically generating with the flow. And here I have my Power App that is connected to that library. This is my video portal, where users can play the videos directly inline in the Canvas Power App. This works on the browser experience as well as on mobile devices. I have leveraged the categorization as filters on the gallery. So based on the tags that are provided for the video, when the user makes a selection for that specific category, the gallery filters the result. And if I click play, it will play the video in the stream player. And we can style this and design this in different ways since we are in the Canvas Power Apps world and we have full flexibility to design our Power App. If you enjoyed this video, then do like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And thank you so much for watching.